Hi, my name is Daichi. I'm a contributor of 3D Map Japan and Global. Today I would like to explain about our experience and how to make good map data, geospatial data with open community. Today I divided four sessions. Session one and session two, I have to describe some information about the NeoGeographers. And then, session three and session four, we will do the actual hands-on. Maybe you can become the OpenStreetMap mapper. Okay, let's start. Today's my slide. Wait a moment. Okay. Can you show? Today's my title. My session title is Power of Neo Geographer. Session one. Okay, let's start. Already I said I'm a contributor of OpenStreetMap since 2008. Already I have about 10 years. Correctly, 12 years. I have experience with OpenStreetMap community. That is a very famous geospatial mapping platform on the net. And sometimes, maybe usually we can use example Google Maps, Apple Maps, or other maps, web map services. And many times, many people compared Google Maps is good or OpenStreetMap is good, so we can do that too. So Google Maps is very useful too, I love, but sometimes we cannot use we couldn't Google Maps for many any purposes. So that means Google Maps has a Google's license. So if we want to use for second uses, so based on Google Maps, so we cannot, example, you cannot trace, we cannot use for the raw data analysis or something. But OpenStreetMap is an open license. That data set we can use for any purposes. So we can trace on the OpenStreetMap, we can print out or something, or we can duplicate that map data for everyone. Today we want to discuss and we want to share about those knowledge and characteristics. And so you can become the Neo Geographer. I will describe this keyword. Okay. First, this is my history in 2015. So 7 years ago, I went to here. Maybe you know this place name is New York City in United States. My works place at here. Can you remember? Can you guess this place name? Yes, this place is a UN headquarters and conference hall. I think you can find some information. UN headquarters conference hall is very sensitive area. So if you go to here, so before entrance gate, so you have to clear some invitation card and so that your baggage is checked or something, security check. So, and also, generally situation, so every attendees have to take shirts and neckties and official dress code. But this thought can explain, so me and other members are taking only t-shirts, jeans, and very casual dress code. So because those members are all member is a OpenStreetMap community in the world, yes. So that is my collaborators. So from Japan, from US, from European countries, from other countries. Anyway, we did many types of discussion, how to make more good, how to make more good quality map data, how to support for the humanitarian works, so with UN side. So that times, host partner is a UN OCHA. OCHA is a humanitarian works organization in the UN groups. And so sometimes before OpenStreetMap, so UN side made a original map for own works. Example, some disaster, natural disaster happened. So they have to make more very good or useful map data for UN staffs and UN project. But maybe, you know, so disaster or incident happened for the any places. And so this making maps process is very difficult and very hard work. So now we are collaborating with UN side and OpenStreetMap community. So already I said I was joined OpenStreetMap community in 2008. So, and every year, so that open community is extending now in this year. So I've checked this number on the end of January 2021. So recently, OpenStreetMap community has 7 million mappers in the world. So this is a unique OSM account number. And yes, so this is a graph about the extending OpenStreetMap community's situation. And we have, yes, end of January. So we have 7.4 million mappers in the world. And maybe I guess next year, so we will touch the, maybe I guess 8 or 9 million mappers in the world. So, and each mappers are existing in each places. And this is a central of Tokyo, around the central of Tokyo's map. And in Tokyo area, so we have about a few thousand volunteered mappers like this. So the human's icon means a one contributor. And yes, this is a world daily active member. So we have totally about 7 million mappers, but some people, some mappers are working only in the weekend. Some people are working only just one day per month or something. So we can calculate as a statistical data set, and we can analyze. So this is a, that is a daily active members status. Recently, we have about 5,000 active mappers per day. Okay. That is our OpenStreetMap committee's state. And yes, so if you have some questions, so my class, we have the Twitter hashtag. So if you have Twitter account, So please send a question using by this hashtag. So GSI, JICA training. Okay. GSI, JICA training. So maybe, so when I find your question, I will reply. So your question on the Twitter. Okay, let's back to today's our goal. So already I said, so I can share about my experience about the OpenStreetMap community. And today's our goal, so you can become good OpenStreetMap editor. So not user, so you can become the editor. Okay. So if you want to make good map, so you should get geospatial data from geodevices. So that means many times you can bring your smartphone, Android or iOS. So general smartphone has a GPS. So if you want to check your correct position, so very easy. So, and also if you have some good device like the 360 degrees panorama photo camera or drones with camera, so you can take your field situation, environmental situation or something. So, and if you can use your drone, so you can take aerial photo data by your hand. So that is a very important. So if you don't have good device, so that's a very hard work called the making good map. But we have technology. So yes, I have to explain about myself. So yeah, I'm actually OpenStreetMap contributor, and I work as OpenStreetMap Foundation Japan's vice president or something. And also my main work is I'm a teacher. I work with Aoyama Gakuin University in Tokyo area. And yes, I have to teach about how to make good map data, how to use good map, geospatial data information. And also sometimes I work with my company's president. So that is my major works. And yeah, I collaborated with Tokyo University and Kyoto University or other universities as a researcher. So, and I work with open geospatial community, OpenStreetMap, OSGEO community, and other drones community, yeah. And so I have some position, but very important information about me. So I'm a tree climber. So tree climber, that is my hobby. But so I think that's hobby related to the this class and the Neo Geographers works. So I have a tree climber. I'm a tree climber, and I have two licenses for tree climbing. So many times I can climb. And so why I have those hobby? So because I have tree house in the forest, Japan. Yes. So like made by ourselves, DIY process. So about, yes, about 10 years. So every year I went to my tree house and I built some parts. Anyway, so yes, if I want to keep my safety so process, so I have to connect to the tree on the tree, and I can keep the three-dimensional position, my position. So that is very safety. So, and also the tree climbing is very funny and very good experience. So that is my hobby. But it's related with the digital map, GIS technology. So it means, you know, GIS can use a lot of geospatial data as model. Example, digital elevation model or geofeatures model or some remote sensing as a sensor data model or something. Anyway, we call those model means feature, geospatial feature. You know, general GIS system, we can use example layer model. We can divide each layers, elevation layer, so the roadmap layer or atmospheres data or some example sensor data or how to say that semantic map data. Anyway, that layer model is very similar to the real situation, but model is not real. So real world, we have to work on the a lot of situation. How to say that? The water situation, topological situation, air situation, air condition or something. If you can make like the digital twin world, so we have to get a lot of information. So model is a very few but very important data. So very similar but little different. We have to move from real world to model world, and sometimes we have to back to real from model. So every time we have to compare the real world and models situation, models data set on the GIS, and that comparing process, that important data is training data. So if we want to make forest GIS map data set, so we have to make a forest model as detailed data. So example, so now we can use a satellite imagery, we can use a drone, we can detect some three-dimensional LiDAR data or GPS position data or something. So, and many times we can connect that using by the training data. So when I climb on the tree, top of tree, so we can detect the recent example, the trees canopies situation. That is a flower season or something. So that height is what height or something. Anyway, so many times we have to go to the real field, and we can detect many information. Then we have to back to the digital model, and we have to compare real world and data model world. So yes, anyway, today we will do the on only in the house or indoor situation, but many times we have to go to field work. So my tree house is just hobby, but sometimes that hobby will change to that getting training data set in the field. So please keep your field, and please keep your technique for the comparing real world and model world. Yes. This is my Twitter account. So if you have question, so already I shared this class is official hashtag GSI JICA training. So please contact me. Yes. Okay. Yes. Hi. Okay. Let's back to today's main topics. So first session, so I have to explain about this keyword, neo-geographer. Neo-geographer. And maybe we can divide another word is old geographer. What different? Neo-geographer and old geographer. Example, I was old geographer 16 years ago. 16 years ago. In this year, today, this year is 2021. So, and 16 years ago means 2005. So, before 2005, I was old geographer. I divided left side and right side. Left side means old geographer. Right side is neo geographer. So, and I picked up the characteristics about old geographer and neo geographer. Old geographer is a kind of cartographer, surveyor, scientist, government person, and forester. Yeah, maybe you can understand. So old geographer is a professional uses. And right side, neo geographer means hobby user, Google Maps API lovers, and mashup engineers, and UGC, user generated content, and CGM, customer generated media. So like the YouTube or as a SNS or some the crowdsourcing platform and social network like the Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram, LinkedIn, anyway. So those user neo geographer is a hobby use. So I think so that based idea is different. And 2005, that is a threshold year. What happened? Maybe you know. So that logo is very old. It's Google. Google Maps and Google Earth launched in 2005. So, yes. And this year, 2005, I remember February. February is Google Maps launched month. And 2005, June, is Google Earth launched timing. Anyway, so that before Google and Google Geo, before Google Geo services and after Google Geo services, the situation was changed. And the basic technologies changed too. Example, old geographer are using, recently using shapefile and map info file, and GeoT file, like the special geospatial format. And after Google, so neo geographer are using XML, like the KML or GML or something, and also database. So we can use SQL based on the PostGIS, Postgres or MySQL or something as a database. And API, so Google Maps or other Mapbox API, so general web mapping API. It can control using by the JavaScript programming or something. So anyway, so that based technologies changed by the Google's geo service threshold. And the old geographer using shapefile or to shapefile via processing. So file orientation idea. And NeoGeographer is an API and database orientation. So if we want to get good data, so we can request some API and or SQL. So we can get a result as a KML data set or GeoJSON file or XML. So, and we can pass. Anyway, so the basic idea is behind. So NeoGeographer using mainly API and database orientation idea. So, okay. And I think this is in my opinion. So I think the most huge NeoGeographers community is, I think, Google Earth users community. So because Google Earth unique download number already so 10 billion, so out of 1 billion users exist in the world. And this data provided from Google in 2011. So, yes. So, yeah, about 1 billion users means very similar to the China's population. So, I guess. So, maybe now we can use Google Earth on the web browser and the smartphone, tablet. Anyway, I think in 2021, this year, I guess over 2 billion or 3 billion users on the world. That is a Google Earth community's situation. I think that is a kind of NeoGeographers community. And today, so we have to share about the OpenStreetMap. That is a, another NeoGeographers community. Yes. Okay, this is OpenStreetMap community's activity. I will show maybe. So this is a 2008, 12 years ago, OpenStreetMap community's situation. So, and this is a city in the UK, and 2008. So this movie can explain about OpenStreetMap community's activity. White flash means someone added the road or building shapes or coastlines as geospatial features. So in the into the OpenStreetMap database. So 2008, so this year was made by the Japan or US or UK or European countries. And so sometimes other area is flashing. And please look at the India. India is flashed for the whole India area. And that data provided from European countries map company donated. So, and US side, US government published the open map data. That name is Tiger data. So we combined as OpenStreetMap, just one database set. Let's back to my slide. So OpenStreetMap is like the free wiki world map. Everyone can edit. Everyone can add many geospatial information. And like the Wikipedia. So, and very similar. And, but maybe, you know, Google Maps is free. So maybe if you can download, you can use as free for the Google Maps, Google Maps applications. And so, but that free means no budget. So, free budget. So, and we are thinking free means freedom. So, if you want to use Google Maps, so that only viewing and checking those information with correct position, that is no problem. But if you want to use for the second use based on Google Maps, they cannot allow. Because there is very but sensitive license, Google license. So, and that OpenStreetMap is a open platform, license is open, and everyone can edit, everyone can trace, everyone can use for second uses purposes. So you can modify, example, so if you find a English name map, you can translate, you can copy, you can duplicate, and you can publish as a atlas. So you can do. So that is a freedom license. So first version of OpenStreetMap, they chose Creative Commons CC by SA license, like the Wikipedia. Wikipedia's license is a Creative Commons CC by SA 3.0, yes, that license. And Creative Commons is has a group of licenses for online digital contents. So maybe we can choose a very sensitive license and very freedom license. So, and this figure means left side is a copyright, very sensitive license. And the right side means a free license, like that very, most freedom license is public domain without license. And we Creative Commons defined each situation. So non-commercial situation or share-alike license situation. So anyway, without non-commercial license, so CC by SA, CC by, and CC by ND, those license data can use for commercial uses. So, and OpenStreetMap, first version of OpenStreetMap license is CC by SA. And today's this class's document is, I defined CC by SA too, and Wikipedia are using CC by SA. That is a share alike. So we defined this document as CC by SA. You can copy, you can duplicate, you can translate in your language, very useful. But if you want to duplicate that content, have to keep this same license, CC by SA. That means share alike, share alike. Anyway, so, first version of OpenStreetMap, we used CC by SA license, but we understand, oh, Creative Commons license cannot support the fact data without creativity. So that means map data is a database on OpenStreetMap platform. So database, means the example, there is a building, there is a river, there is a mountain. Those information is not creative data. So that is just fact data. So, fact data cannot define as creative license. So that is the problem. So okay, we understand. We have to change from creative license to fact data license. So, and 2000, I remember 2012. So OpenStreetMap data license changed from CC by SA to open database license. So open database license is a database license. And so we, that function is very similar to the CC by SA. Everyone can use, everyone can duplicate, everyone can use for the second uses. But license, OpenStreetMap have to keep that license types. ODBL data will keep as same ODBL license. So that is a share alike ideas. So yes, and Google Maps. So first version is totally free, and but they changed the free model to the business model. 2011, so Google Maps API changed for the purchasing model, and many companies changed from Google Maps to OpenStreetMap. Recently, so yes, many companies are changing to OpenStreetMap now. So what is open? So many companies can use open data on the open license. Yes, I chose very famous companies logo like this. Tesla, Toyota, Uber, Facebook. Yes, many, many companies are using OpenStreetMap as the commercial services. Example, Pokemon Go. Pokemon Go is a famous geospatial gaming platform. And 2017, so they changed the map data from Google Maps to OSM. So Casio is a very famous watch company. So, and they have the ProTrek brand for outdoors activity. And that's the latest version of Casio's data watch can bring map data based on Google Map and OpenStreetMap data via Mapbox API. Anyway, so OpenStreetMap data can use the offline situation. If this watch cannot connect to the internet, but user can bring the duplicated map data on the watch. And Facebook has using map data on the SNS communication, and Instagram was a tool. Anyway, many situations, so the position data linked, example that shop information or something. And I chose just one function. That name is Crisis Response Hub. Crisis Response Hub is a kind of information hub for that disaster or incident situation. And if natural disaster happened, a typhoon or earthquake, so we can confirm my family and my friend's situation or his live in the disaster affected area related to the map. And so, yes, like the person finder. So, and also we can share about the volunteer information for that providing information and receive request information. So Facebook crisis response maps can provide that red point and green point. Red point means someone helped, someone send a help message. So please, I cannot move. So please share about today's evacuation place or something. And I cannot speak in Japanese or something. So and someone said, okay, I can speak in English or Chinese or other language, so I can help for your translation or something. So someone added as a green point. Maybe so this matching system will work for that many people's safety. And those data are plotted on the maps based on OpenStreetMap. So, and open, yes, already. This is an example about the Mapbox, MapQuest map. And this is a OpenStreetMap example. So many people are mapped This is a Japanese traditional castle, and this is a golf course, and so this is the center of Tokyo as a black and white map for printing. So, and if you want to change the styling, so you can do like this. So, and the 3D mapping, you can add the elevation attribution. So, like this, we can make a new gaming system or some indoor mapping. So, you can extend, you can implement more useful map data. So, OpenStreetMap is a very useful license, open license. You can copy, you can modify, you can use for second uses. And so OpenStreetMap is a topological data. If you want to make a car navigation system, so the OpenStreetMap map data has a road type, and road means a center of road. So if you want to calculate a network analysis, so very closest place is here, where is very closest area, so you can calculate using by the routing algorithms. And yeah, many companies can use because that data is commercial uses license. And so we are sharing for the world map. So, and you can print out, you can provide those tactile map for the blind people. Yes. And Microsoft, many companies are supporter for the OpenStreetMap community. Microsoft has an example commercial service. The name is Bing Maps platform. And they are providing satellite imagery and aerial photo data for our community. So we can trace based on my Bing map. So, but Google Maps are very sensitive data. We cannot use for that editing map, Google OpenStreetMap data. So, and OpenStreetMap data set divided each types of object, point data, we call node, and line data, we called way, and polygon data, we called closed way, so, and area. And we can define the relation as a group. So, like, sorry, in Japanese, but maybe you can understand. So, and OpenStreetMap object, data object has attribution data. So, with that road name, type of road, natural road, private road. So, we can define as key and value. So, that is the XML database, key and value. And we can define into the each way or area or node, and every editing history recorded as change set. So we can check. So when, who, where, and which data added. So we can check all data data set. And many times. So we can collaborate with GPS logging data and aerial photo data from the Maxa or Microsoft Bing or Mapbox, Esri. So many companies are supported. And if some company donated the good map data, we can import. Example, in Japan, we received Yahoo Japan's data set or Japanese government side data set. And yes, NSDI, United States and other countries, sometimes they are government side has open data as NSDI. So we can import those data into the OpenStreetMap. So yes, OpenStreetMap community was born in 2004, UK, that founder. And generator is Steve Cost. He's a very clever guy. And after that, he extended the OpenStreetMap community in the world. And Japanese community, OpenStreetMap Japan, was born in 2008. And after that, we made an official organization. The name is OpenStreetMap Foundation Japan. So, and we make many document and agreement between the company side and the government side. So, and we shared many, many geospatial information as a GPS data or photo data or map data. And yes, now OpenStreetMap community is growing. So yes, the time. So next session, I will explain about how to collaborate with local people. See you soon, and please take a break time. Hi, bye.